Today's video is brought to you by Card Kingdom. And right now you can get this sweet scoop soldier sticker when you order over on cardkingdom.com. Just mention in your order notes that you want a scoop soldier sticker when you check out. Hey everyone, welcome back to Commander Clash. This week we are doing something special, a special restriction that is focused on Magic Online. This is the 5-ticket challenge week where each of us have built a deck with a budget restriction of only 5 tickets. For people who don't know Magic Online currency, 1 ticket is roughly $1 US. So each of these decks are roughly the cost of $5, 5 tickets online. And the reason why we're doing this is because for anybody who has a Magic Online account, you can sign up right now to Cardhoarder's free loan program. You can have a loan account that has a loan balance of 5 tickets. And as long as you stay under that 5-ticket mark, you can just keep, you know, borrowing and returning cards, 5 tickets worth of cards at a time, and you can build full commander decks. So for people who are in the midst of quarantine, which is probably most of the audience right now, and can't play Magic on, can't play Commander in person, you either do it on the webcam, which is totally fine. But if you want an alternative and you want to try out different cards that you don't own, you could definitely do it right now on Magic Online with these Cardhoarder loan accounts. So it's a really cool opportunity, and we're just going to showcase some of the decks that you can actually be building this week. We're going to be building just in general with the 5-ticket loan balance. So let's start off with Seth. What deck are you running?
So normally I play decks that are built around like some of the more obscure commanders a lot of the time, but I thought because of the theme of this week with the 5-ticket week, I wanted to see if I could take a pretty popular commander but build a 5-ticket version of it. So maybe you, like, I don't know, have this deck in paper but you want to try to play it for free on Magic Online. So I ended up going with Arcades the Strategist, which not only is one of the most popular commanders according to EDH Rec over the last 2 years, it also draws a lot of cards. So my deck has a lot of defenders, a lot of walls, so I get to draw cards with my commander and then hopefully go on the offensive by allowing them to attack, deal damage equal to their toughness, and win with combat damage. So basically cheap Arcades with lots of card draw and actually some pretty cool shenanigans.
Wow, I like the fact that you focus on the combat part of the commander, because I thought you were just going to be like, oh yeah, I'm going to just draw a lot of cards and that would be it. That would just like be the end of the sentence. But you're like, oh, I'm going to go into combat, which is new and exciting.
I feel like because Magic Online has been crashing so much, I got to actually try to kill people now, because or else Moto's just going to win. So it's actually made me a little bit more aggressive just to race the Moto clock.
We're on a clock, yeah, for sure. Just, you know, like if we go beyond turn 11 or so, there's a very strong chance that Moto will get fed up and just be like, all right, I win now. I'm taking over. All right, very sweet. Next up, we got Richard. What deck are you running?
All right, I see your commander drawing cards, and I raise you a Tatyova Benthic Druid. I was kind of lazy. I'm like, I don't know about this restriction, even though for years we built decks for 20 ticks or less. So I was like, okay, it's an uncommon commander. How expensive can that be? It's ramp. How expensive can that be? The answer is not very expensive. So I have a lot of ramp. I have an uncommon commander. I have a lot of landfall synergies and things relating to drawing cards. I actually went 10% under budget because I'm an overachiever. I'm at 4.5 ticks. The equivalent deck in paper would set you back $240. So even though 1 tick is $1, the price of cards on Magic Online are significantly cheaper, especially if they are obscure commander cards that aren't played in tournament formats like Standard and Modern. You get this huge difference in prices. So I'm going to roll with this $250 deck or $240 deck that's 4.5 ticks online.
Yeah. Also, to add to that with the price disparity, the only commanders that I would say are actually very expensive on Magic Online that kind of meets their paper prices are the ones that come from the commander sets, because those aren't opened heavily on Magic Online. So Which kind of sucks, because a lot of the most popular commanders end up being the ones that come from, like, the Brawl decks, for example, like Korvold or Chulainn, or the commander sets. So when people, you know, look at Magic Online and they see, like, oh, can we build, you know, this deck for really cheap? Well, I mean, if you're picking from the commander sets, like Commander 2015 or whatever, those are going to be kind of expensive. But if you pick any commander from a standard set, chances are it's going to be really cheap. So, yeah, like, Tatyova is an uncommon. She's going to be under one ticket easily, and then you could build the rest of the deck super easily. All right, next up, we got Krim. What deck did you run?
This week, I am running Talrand, Sky Summoner. Oh, now, I thought it was going to be pretty difficult to go under five ticks, but I'm also a little bit of an over, or I guess underachiever, I don't know. The thing here is I am currently sitting at 3.59 ticks.
Mm-hmm.
So it's crazy just because, like, some of these cards I just didn't know they were that cheap. And some of this is also just really pricey. Like, I really had to shell out on some of this stuff. Well, shell out as in 81 cents.
Oof.
Or 81 ticks. Sorry.
Is that how much mana drain costs online?
Uh-oh. Ooh, I don't know. I can't confirm or deny. Like, so my deck could be 5.3 ticks outside of the mana drain. But, you know, everything else is good. we'll see if it's in the deck or not.
Every time.
But the deck is, it has a counterspell, like, you know, like a little bit more my playstyle of controlling deck. But there are some cool things in here that I just really, really didn't expect to be this cheap. So I was pretty excited to play it.
Awesome. Yeah, I've built Talrand before. It was like one of the first budget commanders I did. And it's like every random blue instance suddenly becomes so much better when you generate a 2/2 flyer as part of the bonus effect. So yeah, Talrand's a great choice for this week.
Yes. yes. Talrand. Yes.
Very sweet.
Very good.
Well, I see you're underachieving, and I'll lower the bar a little bit, actually. Because my deck is Feather Voltron. This is a Feather deck, Boros. I saw everybody picked a blue commander. So I was like, you know what? I can't pick blue. And I have to pick something aggro because I didn't actually expect Seth to actually be attacking. So I thought it was like the burden was on me to be the red aggro player yet again. So I busted out Feather the Redeemed. This is kind of like a Voltron-y deck that is all about attacking in the air, lots of instant sorceries and janky cards. And the budget on this one is currently 3.56 tickets online. So pretty low, pretty cheap. And yeah, nice. It should be fun. I'm excited for it.
You said 3.6?
3.56.
Oh, 5.6.
Yes.
Wow. Just had I just, to go right under.
I knew you were like 3.59, and I was like, you know what? I can't have this. I can't have this.
Let me just tell Lane. Weird. I actually have to take something out too.
Yeah. Hold on. Did I say 3.59? I meant. Also, by the way, this deck and four other decks are available on or have been covered on an article/video that recently got released, I think, probably before this video comes out, I think. So if you like this deck or it just fails horribly, but you're just morbidly curious at how Feather should play, then you can check that out and four other decks now on MTG Goldfish. Check that out. But first, watch this video and then check out that thing too. That would be great. Like and subscribe. All right. With the deck intros out of the way, let's hop into the game. Did you like the like and subscribe call to action?
That was a good call to action. I'm not sure if the video is up or not, nor did I disclose the name of the video. So there's no way for you to find it. Yeah. It was great.
I don't even like the title right now. It's five more free EDH decks. That sounds awful. I need something better. By the way, leave a comment if you think you have a better title. If this part of the video is still in, I don't know what the editor does with it. He has full reign.
We're going to have a montage of all the things Tomer thinks is not in the recording, but actually is in the recording.
Oh, boy. Okay, so this has two lands. Not enough to cast my commander. That's probably not good enough. I'm going to mull.
Huh.
All right, I'm going to just update this. Oh, lands. That's not good.
I have lands and that's a one lander, so we will keep it.
Let me just mull the six.
Oh, Tomer with the greed.
All right.
If it makes you feel better, I kept a two lander.
Is that because you cut 20 lands out of your deck?
No. I have like 37 lands.
Oh, wow. The discipline to cut 30 cards without cutting a land.
You know what? Yeah, I'll keep this one.
It was not easy. I had like 30. Yeah, as I was telling everyone this morning, I had 37 or 36 cuts in the morning.
Oh,
I had to
figure out.
The casual, I have to trim 36 cards from my deck.
That's a brave one. Usually, I go down to like 103 cards, and then I'm like, I give up. I'll just sleep on it and make some cuts right before Commander Clash, because I'm forced to actually cut at that time. But 30 cards is a lot.
Oh, yeah. Yeah, see, like, I can't do that. If I wait till last minute, what's going to happen is I'm just going to end up cutting my lands.
If you wait till last minute, you'll be like me, where I'm just waiting for the bot while everybody else is waiting for the recording to start.
It's okay. Thanks to Tomer, I'm able to get my water breaks.
I'm surprised you got 30-some extra cards on 5-ticket week. Like, that's actually kind of that shows how many, like, really cheap and semi-playable cards there are on Magic Online.
Yeah. That's what I meant. Like, I was seriously so surprised by the fact that I'm not only like under 5 ticks, but I'm like pretty under, right? Like, I'm a whole like 1.5 or whatever, 1.41 ticks like under.
Mm.
So yeah. Like it was just absolutely mind blowing to me. I just was not expecting that. I thought I'd be like sitting there like $10 over or something like that and trying to figure it out.
Yeah, I mean, most cards online, like, there's even a format that's Magic Online exclusive called Penny Dreadful, where the only cards that are available in that format are 0.01 tickets, so the cheapest possible, other than basic lands, which are always free. Like, you can just go, there's, like, free accounts where you can just get basic lands for free, so they're counted as zero. So there's Penny Dreadful. Usually it's played one versus one, but I remember one time we actually did Commander Clash on it, and there's some filters. I think Scryfall supports it, but there might be other filters as well where you basically filter out all cards that are over 0.01 tickets. So you have the Penny Dreadful format restriction essentially. So it's really easy to build a deck just around that. Like, and then every single deck you would make for Commander would be less than a ticket, right? Because if every single card is 0.01 and then basic lands themselves are zero, you could just, you know, knock out a really, really cheap deck.
All right. Is Modo painfully slow for you guys?
Yes.
yes, it is.
It's a little slow.
Also, my F2 button's not working. Oh, it's probably 2 not now.
Good to make it through this game.
So I am so scared.
So also, as much as we're trying to hype up Magic Online, because legitimately, we're not getting paid by Wizards of the Coast on this, by the way. I think what? Wizards of the Coast tries its hardest not to make you play Magic Online, by the way.
Sorry. Sylvan Library is under... How many
Sylvan Library is
card?
0.02 tickets. Yep.
Broken.
Yep.
Broken.
Survival of the Fittest.
I googled it, okay. 0.4. On a site called MTGGoldfish, and Mana Drain is only 40 cents. Okay, so he has a Mana Drain, guys. Get him.
Crim, no. He probably does. There's so many cheap counter
spells.
Crim probably has...
I like how Crim just lets the Sylvan Library resolves.
He wants to ramp just, like 10 mana with Mana Drain, not 2, okay?
Yeah. He's waiting for my turn.
Yeah, what's Tomer doing?
That's my disappointed sound.
It does sound disappointed, actually.
No, don't do it.
What is this primal rage?
Wave break hippocamp.
Oh boy, that's a good sign of counterspells.
Yeah,
impending.
What?
It wants you to cast spells during our turn.
I mean,
what would a mono blue deck cast during?
I said I wanted
turns?
A clock.
Okay, so this time, this video I'll actually cast Mono my commander, because like deck doesn't do anything without commander.
Hey, Tomer, casting your commander.
Yeah. I never forget my commander. I never forget. Oh my god.
I am super worried about Feather.
You should be.
Didn't we have a Feather game before, and it was just like absolutely dominant?
Absolutely not.
And guess who was using it? Tomer. And guess what he had? Sunforger.
What? Why?
And you know what happened? Everybody, like, I don't think you politic with the Feather deck,
first
right?
of all, this has never happened. Second of all, I don't have any recollection. Third of all, let's keep things in the past and not drag things into the future holding grudges.
Says
the Feather deck
player.
Says the Tatyova player, who we all know is absolutely disgusting. Arcades is going to draw a billion cards just casting free walls. And we have a Waybreak Hippocamp that says draw a card.
and a Hippocamp.
But I'm the bad guy because I cast my commander. Feather. I didn't even cast my commander the entire last game, all right? I was helping you out. I was being nice. By the way, so that recording, that commander clash goes up tomorrow from the time that we're recording this. I am terrified. I'm probably just not going to read any of the comments, by the way. Just going to skip it.
I think I've already said it before and I'll say it again. I just don't know. I've never actually seen a point where like the comment section isn't understanding.
Yeah, for sure.
I think that's my complaint that, comment section, you could definitely step it up. You know? Like you just get a little bit of grilling, you know?
Arch Veraska, you're going hard on that.
Strip mine him.
Seth, I'm sorry. I got to take a little off the top, dude.
You can attack me. I promise I won't block.
Weird. I trust me. I don't have what's that? I don't have rookie mistake in this deck.
Is that a card?
Oh yeah,
sounds like a battle bond card.
It's I forgot. I think it's from Ikoria.
Is there really a card named Rookie Mistake?
Yeah. I forgot what it was called. I think it is Rookie Mistake.
Oh yeah, it's from Corset 2021. Right. There is a card called Rookie Mistake.
All right, let's make Feather red for a second.
Oh boy. It's begun.
Gains haste. They draw a card.
It says draw a card, but it's really like draw.
What's wrong with it? It's
a
just
card
drawing
every
one card.
Turn.
Crimson Wasps? That's nice, dude.
That's only
nice,
one dude. Mana for Mana Drain, by the way. That's not.
I feel like your whole deck, Tomer, for the most part, won't give me many solid Mana Drain targets.
Blue Elf Man will blast it. He's fallen. He's fallen for your trap.
Yeah.
Even though you could have done it before this.
Yeah, I had to wait until you did that.
There's gotta be like destroy target monocolored creature. Get the black cards in here.
Yeah. Oh man. There's no hard removal. right now I don't see that much
for
hard
yourself,
removal.
I have Prey Upon.
I have soft.
Okay. I might have a little.
Alright, I'm kind of afraid of that 4 untapped mana. I don't know what he would have that could like ambush my Feather and kill it, but
I don't play anything.
Etherize,
I'm actually this is more of a card to like flex on people, the Hippocampus or whatever. I'm actually all sorceries.
I'll just hit Richard because he wins every single game.
Whoa.
Oh yeah, actually. Whoa, Tomer. Hey, hold on. I got this crazy idea. What if we don't dunk on each other in the early game?
We're just like quickly falling into the exact same trap as every single week.
We even acknowledge it, but go right ahead first into it. Yeah, you're right. Richard does win all their games. Anyways,
huh,
I'm going to attack
funny
Tomer.
That. Yeah. I'm sure Tatyova will be fine. Let's just kill each other and make it really easy for Richard.
Is Tatyova even really scarier than Feather? Well, I actually don't.
Well,
I feel I have the least scary commander here. Usually Tatyova's pretty scary, but this week.
It's because there's no fetch lands.
Sylvan libraries.
If Tatyova has like the full repertoire of fetch lands, it gets really scary, especially when you have like fetch lands plus like Summer Bloom effects where you can play multiple extra lands per turn, and then like a Crucible of Worlds, so you can start like just replaying the same fetch land over and over again from the graveyard. That becomes super scary with Tatyova, but without any fetch lands, I think like a third of Tetyova's power goes away. Not to say that it's not scary, it's just less scary, I would say.
I guess you still get all the like cultivates and that type of stuff, because those are all super. Migration's Path, for example, those are all like super cheap, I think. Yeah,
that's 4 mana for Mana Drain, I'm just saying.
I mean, Arcades is coming. You want to hold the Mana Drain for Arcades and get your mana.
I'm not going to cast anything if you leave your mana up, Grim. I will pass the turn. We'll do this. I'm not letting you counter my Arcades. It's not going to happen.
He's going to discard the hand size. Don't listen to him. He's not going to give up value.
Unwind.
Untap 3 lands.
Wow. Oh.
I hate you all. I hate you, Tober, for playing 1 mana spells.
Look, let's just nip this in the bud, all right?
Wow.
That's a good choice.
Counter that one, too.
Well, Tober.
So you still get to counter my Arcades? Kill the feather, Grim.
Look. We're all having
it's
fun.
Personal now.
You need to get your revenge.
Look.
Talrand just took out my card draw.
But I didn't take out Talrand.
Abby can't keep one for wanting us. It's okay.
Yes.
Everyone relax. All right. Just chill.
Now you get to play Arcades.
Maybe.
I'm still worried about Crim countering. I'll just cast a cultivate.
That's 3 mana.
That's ramp too. You hate ramp, Crim. Counter that.
Whoa.
Oh my goodness. Oh, okay. Uh-oh. God's willing. Oh, God's willing every turn. Kill my feather. I've seen this before in standard and historic and every other format.
Oh my god.
I hate feather. I actually almost wonder if Feather is a mistake card, but that other cards
Wait,
have been so...
Hand, not command zone. All right. Hopefully it works.
Are we just never killing Tomer's commander now?
What do you mean?
This is exactly what happened.
I can't even change twice last time
Feather showed up.
You need a counterspell for when he recasts it, right?
Oh, well, I hope. Yeah, but on my screen, I can't change if it goes to exile, if it stays in exile or not. So I'm just going to hope that this works properly. We'll find out together.
Staying in exile would be super
sweet. Yeah,
that
would make me sad. Let's see how this pans out. Oh, it worked.
Ooh, look, there's a feather.
Hey, finally worked. Oh, you don't get to untap. I'm sorry.
I almost wonder if feather is like a mistake card, but there's been so many broken cards in standard that it hasn't actually gotten to be that busted.
It's
yeah.
It is, by definition,
it is not a mistake.
Yeah, in standard, it doesn't, like in 1v1 formats, it doesn't seem too busted. In commander, it's pretty obnoxious. But also, I'm just going to throw it out here. You're all 3 blue players. 2 of you are Simic. I don't know how the Boros deck is really the bad guy here.
Oh, I'm 100% at targeting Tomer. Like,
yeah, I think you're already arch enemy.
Yeah, like I'm 100% targeting Tomer. However I can do it, I will.
You're like, you're counterspell.deck. I'm just...
That doesn't mean anything.
Everybody, stand back for a second. Counterspell.deck is upset that the feather player is stopping their counters / stupid nonsense.
Oh, I don't care if you stop my counterspells. It's the fact that your cards all come back.
I just have a healthy fear because I'm pretty sure last time you were Archenemy from like turn 3 and you still won. And then we played another game and you did it again. Like, I think that's how Feather went.
Everybody
You're
just,
correct, Seth. That is how it went.
Everybody just chill. All right. Just chill. Okay.
Are we dead? Are we dead, Tomer? Have you locked us out already?
No. I'm just gonna draw some cards. Yikes!
Oh,
who was that?
I think it should have said the first instant or sorcery each turn. Like, we see that restriction on like Wavebreak Hippocamp in a lot of cards. They've done that with a lot of cards recently. I think that might have been fairer.
I mean, yeah. Yeah, I think that definitely would make this... I mean, it, like, the card just feels ridiculous, right? After a certain point, like, you know, it's just, like, hopeless.
I think we need Armageddon. This is... If you Armageddon this week, Richard, I won't be bad. Because then Tomer can't keep recasting his card draw, so...
you know what? I'll just in the stay silent. I'll be fine. I got rid of the Hippocramp, and everybody's now upset at me for taking out the card draw engine.
Okay, what's the worst that I'm doing?
He has a cloud shift?
Yeah.
Yeah, so...
I could have answers to this, maybe.
I wish I had three
fairy. But I need more mana.
If I had three fairy, you could just, like, embarrass me.
I think three fairy should be banned from Commander.
Oh, yeah. I personally don't think a single Planeswalker needs to get banned from Commander, because Planeswalkers never live for that long.
The new Teferi seems pretty disgusting. I just don't like the idea of, like, turn two, you know, turn one Sol Ring, turn two new Teferi, and just like, okay, just go for it.
Ooh.
You can counter that. It's five mana, Krim.
Oh, I have an, I'm just going on the aggro plan.
Oh.
Everyone's got to cast their commanders while Krim is tapped out.
Yes.
This is the window.
Oh, wait a minute. I need another blue source.
There are free spells, though. I really like, what's the one where it's you discard a island plus another card? That one is dope.
Foil?
It's foil or thwart. I always get the two mixed up. I guess it's foil.
There's also my bounce spell. That costs, I just have to bounce some islands.
Yeah, it's, I think that's thwart.
But there's also the counter spell.
Why'd I do this now? I'm an idiot. Okay.
Richard does have a fetch lands.
Of course he does. But he has budget ones.
Just as planned.
Okay. But no, that's fine. Richard just drawing a billion cards, that's fine.
You're doing the same thing, and my only card draw got exiled.
Well, I have to pay one mana for each card I draw. Richard just has to play lands, all right? The thing he's doing anyway.
The two value commanders. I don't know which one I don't want to lose to more, actually.
wait for Seth.
Oh, but I have to cast very bad walls. I think I have the hardest commander to draw cards with.
Poor me.
I am going to do it, though. Arcades.
Welcome, Arcades.
And then... Look at the power. Look out. The vines are coming for you.
Very nice.
It's a 3-3.
I do like that this week I can play bounce lands. I've gotten in the habit of never playing them because of strip mine, but I don't think you can afford strip mine this week. Like, it's too expensive for the budget. So I think my bounce lands might be safe. I really tried.
Is strip mine too much online?
I almost cut everything out. It's not like expensive, but it's like a couple bucks.
Yeah, it is played in like, what, Legacy or something? I don't know, some dead format.
Vintage a little bit, and then probably like CDH? Yeah, it's like about two ticks for the cheapest version.
I mean, I put it in most of my paper decks.
I put it in all my Commander Clash decks. I almost tried to cut two tickets worth of walls just to play a strip mine, but
whoa,
I decided that was probably a bad plan.
No! I was distracted! No!
What happened? Oh, you were gonna...
He just skipped cards through his entire turn.
I'm over here playing Metal Gear Solid. I'm trying to go stealth. If I don't say anything, Tomer won't do anything, so I'm just gonna pass.
Dang it, it worked. You figured me out. Alright, I'm just gonna do this.
Oh, Crimson Wisp. Where'd that come from?
Weird.
You know, curious. Tomer, if you would have targeted your feather with swords, it would have gone back to your hand.
Wait, why does it skip my main phase?
Cast it twice.
I could have cast other...
Set?
No, my main phase, it stops on my turn. I cast one spell and it's like...
Arena. It doesn't skip your main phase.
No, I could have cast other things.
Do you... Is it clicked? Like, did you accidentally unclick the main phase stop?
Oh, I feel so bad.
Turn off auto heal? I don't know. Every single time I update it, like, just does things. Oh, man, Moto. Oh, I'm so sad.
Not to the feather deck. Oh, man.
All right.
I'm sorry.
All right, Krim. All right, Krim. Yeah, I know you want me to attack so you can make, like, a billion.
Sure. Maybe. I mean, you can just always cloud shift your feather away anyways, right?
Okay, he's stuck on lands, though.
I am.
He can't cloud shift that many times. We can get rid of feather, then he can't recast feather.
I tried. I already tried. I did my part. I tried to snap, but, you know, it's up to you two now, because I'm just going to counter whatever he plays.
Wow!
You mean the cloud shift?
Anything, pretty much, outside the Crimson
Wisp. I blew up one of your things, Krim. Come on, Chuck.
It was my main thing that I cared about. It was my seahorse.
You didn't tell me that. You were very blasé about it when you cast it. I don't think you even said anything.
You're right. I mean, it's because I wasn't trying to draw attention to it.
Why is it skipping my second main?
Oh.
Did you stop on my turn.
Through your turn?
No.
It seems like you F6 through your turn.
It does feel like you F6 through your turn.
Just right click and then
I've been pressing 2 the entire time. I just missed a draw.
I don't know what 2 does. I remember we did the Moto tutorial, they changed what 2 did.
2 is just press okay.
And maybe 1 is okay.
Boy.
Yeah. I think there's a way to like pop up all the commands, but I don't know what that is because I don't use them.
Yeah, I would not press 2 anymore because I know for a fact they changed the definitions of like 1 and 2 and things like that at some point.
This is a great advertisement Moto, for Magic Online.
By the way, get into Moto.
Man, just missing land drops now. This feels bad.
That's what he wants us to think. Oh, poor me.
Yes, yes, this is all according to plan.
Like, all is, though. And then you're going to win.
Okay, how do you feel about me having a Royal Elemental, taking Feather, you counter the Cloud Shift, and then I just hold on to Feather?
Whoa, but then that Royal Elemental is going to get your Talrand and my Arcades. And
you get to steal everything, right? One from
everyone. Yeah. But I get rid of Feather.
Well, every time he plays a land, he gets to steal something else.
He also gets both your commanders.
Oh, I would rather face Feather than have
a hard bargain. I'll just play a land and draw a card.
Oh, playing a land. I can't even press 2 now. I'm just going to press okay and hope for the best.
I think you should press 1.
Stop on my turn and then stop on my turn.
I think you should be pressing 1 and not 2.
Maybe I don't have a counter spell. Who knows?
Do you really want to counter this?
Is it a Royal Elemental?
It's a Moonfolk.
Oh, very funny. Very funny. Okay,
I can make 1/1 birds that pair up against your 2/2 drakes.
I'm not coming at you, Krim, if you're worried about that. And I'm just going to try to draw cards, so.
I mean, so was I, but that was taken from me. So, October, I do not.
Wow. All right. I mean, he has the Tatyova on the battlefield, so he's just going to keep bouncing and replaying lands drawing
then I don't,
all the cards.
I don't make more land drops.
Remember how we said we were not going to just let Richard win?
Yeah, yes. But then you go and play Feather and you blow up my card draw.
You're counterspelled on deck. How am I the bad guy here? I don't understand.
Because I'm 1-for-1-ing.
I'm 1-for-1-ing too.
No, you're like 50-for-1.
I just do it consecutively.
Seth's on the value train now.
Everybody's on the value train, but I'm the bad guy and I just skip my turn.
Okay.
Wall of Frost?
The value. Two cards.
Draw 2 cards. Mentor of the Meek's kind of perfect for this deck because none of my stuff has power.
It's not bad. It's good.
Not more lands.
Good value.
More lands.
What did you tap? Oh wait, only if it blocks. I thought it did something else.
Who do we attack? Tomer.
Yeah.
Whatever. Okay.
Is that mana up and a feather?
It's Tomer or Richard. Yeah, you gotta hit one of them.
Feather can't kill Arcades.
Oh, I don't know. Yeah.
Richard is at 29. Just remember that. So he is lowering his health for you.
Tomer, a little off the top. Are you going to do feather shenanigans if I attack you, Tomer?
You think I don't have answers?
Answer honestly.
if he tries anything too wild, I mean,
right. He'll just press the wrong modal buttons. He'll be fine.
Yeah. There's also that.
All right. I'm trusting in something. Crim, mostly.
Would you look at that? You're trusting I'm helping you, Crim.
Oh, you attack him? Oh, yeah, this wall thing can attack, too.
Yeah, Arcadius handles all of that.
You don't want to sack it to draw a card?
Oh, that's coming. Oh, don't worry.
Wait, that wall of frost is pretty scary.
It's like a 0/7, but yeah, I wouldn't worry about it. It has no power, Richard. It can't hurt that's you. True.
It has no power, yeah.
The problem is if you kill Arcades, then everything does nothing. That's the downside of Arcades decks. You don't really have to kill everything. You just got to like deal with the thing that lets the walls attack.
Well, a lot of the commanders here don't really do much. Well, I guess Tatyova can just like play big green cards, right? Like Avengers on the card doesn't really need Tatyova on the battlefield.
Out of budget.
Yeah, I'm curious what Richard has as finite, like crawl worms? Like what are the cheap big green things?
When you draw enough cards, crawl worms. I don't think it matters.
It's great. I have a force of nature. I only have to pay 4 green every turn, okay? Oh, I'm tempted to return 2 lands just to double block.
You could block with your Maloku.
What is this?
I don't know.
A Drake?
I don't know what's going on. I'll take it.
I'm confused by this.
Woo! I forgot Maloku had flying. All right.
Yeah, I was like, what is next level? What is 4D chess that you're playing?
I thought he was going to cast Rookie Mistake because I don't know what that card does.
Now that is what we call Magic the Gathering.
Next level. Oh, plus Tomer has combat tricks too. He can mess with combat.
Yeah. Feather has all kinds of shenanigans.
I am looking at this board state. Okay.
Ooh, all right. Finally. it took four times when we got rid of it.
but it's so replaceable. He has like a million of those effects.
Oh yeah. But we gotta see more cards from Tomer.
To see how busted his deck is.
How many more things happen?
Ooh, Ryle? Panic.
Yeah, those are cards that I would have liked to keep in my hand.
Titan Strain. Shelter.
Okay.
Okay, oh now his things are really unkillable.
Oh.
Okay.
Crim really is good. I think Crim just wants to go aggro. Although getting rid of the shelter is pretty helpful. Shelter, if you have shelter and cloud shift up, how does Feather ever die?
Don't know, but we're going to find out.
But so now he has cloud shift up, right?
No, he has no mana right now.
Well,
he will
have cloud shift still, yeah.
Yes.
Yeah, he's going to untap.
Okay, yeah. you figured me out.
I mean, yes, we can predict the cloud shift and what his deck does, but how does that alter the game plan? Like the course of like the game right now. That's the only thing.
I think you really are being punished for that last feather game, Tomer. I would not be nearly as scared of feather if it wasn't.
I'm just like objectively looking at the table. I am not the most threatening at the board. I'm just not. And it's just okay.
I am always scared of feather.
Trample and card drop. Kill him. Kill Tomer. Trample. We can't have that. Every turn.
Okay.
Missing those land drops is probably not ideal.
Yeah, skipping my turn is not ideal.
Oh, he's on the blocking plan.
I mean, I just got attacked for 6. And there's a bunch of drakes.
The 6 god. A lot of them.
Valorous stance.
Board is pretty scary.
Double cleave. Ooh. I'm glad that's in the graveyard.
Yeah, I wanted to be aggro this week. It didn't pan out.
Oh, Richard. I legit just forgot Maloku had flying.
The art doesn't really depict it flying. That's the problem. Like,
at what point is that card flying? Sure.
He's
I know that the tokens you make are flying.
Because he lives in the cloud, so he's not flying, he's just really up in the air.
So he's like levitating, right?
Yeah.
But how do you know if he's levitating or not if the picture doesn't show him levitating? It doesn't show his legs. So where is he what's he levitating from?
No one knows. A true magician.
Also, why are the fingers so pointy? Is that a moonfolk thing?
Wow, that's rude. Why are the fingers so pointy?
Look at Maloku. Like, it's like some claws.
I need a blocker, Seth.
Oh, Richard, no!
Okay, wait. Let me stack. Oh, no, I have to choose this already. I mean, he's just got a cloud shift.
I mean, you can steal 2 other commanders, or you could just waste your trigger on mine. I don't know.
I have blocker now. You have Venture Scale. You can still draw cards.
That's not ideal.
Okay, I will use this ability. Yes.
Well, Seth, time for you to enter the chat here. You better find something to do. I'm over here trying to make sure that the feather doesn't lock us out. Richard's over here stealing our stuff.
Making sure the feather doesn't lock us out by locking out everyone.
And you're good, right?
I'm doing my part, okay? I do not like feather decks.
I can't do much without Arcades, though, because all of a sudden my walls can't attack again, so...
Wait, you have, like, high alert and things like that, right? Or are they out of budget?
Well, no, they're... Yes, I do have them... Ooh, Do you want to do that one? How much mana do we have? 8? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Okay. All right, that was actually a good draw. I take it back.
Answer?
What?
It is, actually.
But are you blowing up my board?
No. I just want my commander back.
Let me block.
Cloud Shift only blinks your stuff, right? It can't target anyone's stuff.
Even if it did blink other people's stuff, I think it's going to return it to its owner's control, right?
Yeah, well, I want to kill the Royal Elemental to get my commander back.
Why would I stop you from killing the Royal Elemental?
No.
Okay. Let's do that.
That'll show him.
This is not a generous gift. It's instant. You can cast it any time, Seth.
But I want my commander back now.
Any specific reason why?
So I can draw cards.
Oh. Wait,
there's a 5-man.
Hey.
Oh, boy.
Hey, that's a cool wall. I like that wall.
Awkwardly, Beast Within is like 2 ticks, so you can't. I couldn't fit it under the budget. But Generous Gift is super cheap.
Oh, but you can't pay the extra mana off Mentor on me.
I know. I'm losing so much value.
Oh boy,
might as well.
Yeah, undo.
Tomer.
I just want to draw a couple cards too,
Trample,
you guys.
Kill him.
The Boros deck also wants to draw a few cards. Mother may I?
Boros should not be allowed to draw cards. We have 25 years of Magic's history that tells us that Boros should not be able to draw cards.
All right, now the infinite looping of Generous Gift.
I actually don't have Ghostly Flicker.
Oh. All right.
For now.
So Richard's at 28. Me and Krim are kind of friends this game.
We're friends.
Oh, boy.
What? Tor, are we friends?
I'll get stomped out by it. Like,
I don't want to get counterspell locked out of the game, which is what Talrand is.
Your spells cost
the
1 mana.
The one complaining the most at the table about lockouts is a counterspell dot deck.
You mean
this game doesn't make sense to me.
I would attack Tomer, but I feel a little. Well, he is playing Feather. I was gonna say, I feel
remember
bad,
this
but...
is what happened last time, and then we lost.
Okay, you have the craziest board state, Seth. How much it's mana and card draw do you have on the battlefield?
It's a Wall of Frost. Can anything with a portcullis fine and Wall of Frost be defined as a crazy board state? You know what? For saying I have a crazy board state.
I mean, it is a wall with defender.
Yep. Okay, I'll stay on defense. You're
what?
Here go, Chris.
No, we gotta actually... Oh my gosh.
I feel bad.
What if I quadruple block your triple oh, block man. Your wall? Then you'll feel dumb.
At least hit Richard.
Oh, nice city special.
This'll get him.
The wall frost has to stand back and block all those flyers.
It can stop the elephant token.
Yeah.
Interesting.
Uh-oh.
It's weird that Talrand doesn't fly. Like, why would Maloko make flyers and fly?
Because you can see his legs, it's on a rock. So, obviously.
Well,
it's a fish.
Just because you're not flying at the moment that your picture is taken doesn't mean you don't have the ability. Have you ever seen a bird, like, standing on a rock? It doesn't mean that the bird can't fly. It's just not choosing to at the moment.
So now there's a shields are up.
Just don't play your five mana like feather spell, mana. You know. better leave with the one mana ones. You know?
Yeah, the good thing is your spells are bad enough that they're not really very appealing counter targets. They're all just like one mana draw card.
I mean, that's what Kryn just, like, he countered two of them. He countered the Crypts of the Woods and the Shelter.
I
don't know.
Just
it's good enough for him.
I'm looking for your blink spells, okay? Mostly.
You should cloud shift for value right now. Wait, what is double cleave? Oh, boy. It's a Kithkin card.
Yeah, just double strike.
So, one... I think I just go like. I think I just do this.
Huh.
And then pass.
Huh.
Or not pass. Juke.
Oh boy.
Yep, the 3/4 is really scary when Richard has a Tatyova on the battlefield and Maloka and a Black Blade Reforge and a lot of mana in the Sylvan Library.
I don't know what you expect me
it's
to
pretty
do.
Pretty scary.
I don't have any removal.
Yeah.
I mean, I do, but like it's not permanent.
I didn't attack you, Tomer.
Yeah. No one attacked
friends,
you, Lester.
We're friends now.
Thanks.
We still actually do need to get out from underneath.
Well, underneath what? I don't have this royal thing.
Gee, if only there were some ways to stop those spells instead of the Crimson Wisps and Shelter.
That was just out of straight disrespect.
To draw a card.
That was out of disrespect. I had to do it.
Fair.
Huh. Whenever land enters the battlefield, choose one. Put a 1/1 on target creature.
Kazandu.
Okay.
Is that a problem?
Yeah. It doesn't seem that scary.
I get to healing solve every time I play a land with my commander out.
Boom. So now what you're saying is, Seth, you can hit him.
Hmm.
Oh, I hadn't thought about that. Maybe.
No.
He's asking to get hit.
I think you're misunderstanding. I'm just trying to replenish some life, okay?
Tell me you play Ensnaring Bridge.
Seth, that may not be
staring bridge.
May not be in the budget.
It's way too much for the budget.
That's a card that I just thought would be like one tick, maybe.
Oh, I think it's going to come down because of double masters, but yeah, it's actually pretty expensive. It would be really good in my deck, though. I do have some like budget versions ish. Nothing nearly as powerful, but okay. Similar shenanigans.
You guys leave me alone. You guys leave me alone.
11-11.
Maloku flies. I know this now.
Okay.
I need some flying walls.
Wait, if you attack with Wall of Frost, do I
untap? I'm worried about Richard now.
Only when you block. Huh. The anti-synergies there. Wait, you got the gift thing back, no? You can make an elephant anytime you want.
Yes, I do have the gift thing again.
Yeah, you just blow up the Black Blade.
Boom. Draw some cards.
That's three cards. That's Ancestral Vision.
Yeah. Not bad.
I mean, I think Seth's getting out of hand here.
Eh.
They're all losing. If I had any way to interact with creatures that was not Zendikar Royal Elemental.
Losing to the wall army.
I'm surprised that that Tomer hasn't shown more removal yet.
He has to hold up all his white mana. To
draw engines were dismantled or something. I don't know.
Wait, what is this?
It's another Wall of Blossoms.
You control the dragon? Oh my god. That's another recall. He's gonna...
Yeah.
Oh my god.
I don't have a reliquary tower or anything though, so.
Oh, that feels bad. You might have to discard your extra lands or something.
I could.
Can you blow up the Black Blade?
Why are you blowing up? Why do you want him to? Why do you want to help him? Look at his army.
Are you really scared of the zero power army?
You have 11, 13, 16, 21. 25, 29 power on the battlefield.
So we're worried about the Black Blade?
I mean, we're worried about a lot of things right now. The Tatyova constantly doing things. The Maloku just existing is a problem. And then there's Black Blade and Feather. The Wall Army, that's fine. I like the Wall Army.
Does Krim have an evacuation? How is he going to survive like just one swing at this?
We're friends, and Krim he likes playing for second. I'll kill you last, Krim.
Thank you. As long as you kill me last.
Oh wow! He really does have 20-something power this turn now.
Well, this doesn't have haste itself, unfortunately.
So Seth's down to 70 cards in library.
Give that one haste.
Crashing Drawbridge, if it actually had haste, it would be such a good card. It's still okay. Alright, I mean, that's it. I drew a bunch of cards. I'll discard many of them to hand size.
I drew a lot of cards. I have 30 power. It's okay. Oh, yeah, that's fine.
Not scary.
Because of Primal Rage.
I guess I should attack a little. I can't really attack Richard because he has Maloku. I don't want to anger anyone, though.
You can send some into Krim to call down some drakes.
No, me, the Wall Army and the drakes are friends.
I can live with second place.
Alright.
I'm just gonna wait one more turn.
It's his ploy. He's saying second place, but he's gonna stab you in the back to get first.
No. I'm okay with getting second place.
He's just drafted off of you.
I like all of the walls. I think that's pretty cool.
So we'll discard.
Is there a card that destroy all creatures with like power zero or less? There's gotta be such a card.
I mean, there's what's the 3-mana double white spell? It's like one in white. Slaughter the Strong.
Yeah, but that's like greater, right? Is that toughness though? I think it's like it's based on
No, it's power. It's based on power, yeah.
There's nothing that kills small creatures and leaves the big ones.
There's a bunch of things that are really good in my deck that kill big creatures, but leave zero power creatures.
Retribution of the Meek.
Yeah, that's one.
Oh boy, so you're saying you have a 3-mana in Garrick's Wake.
Yeah, not much removal this week.
It's because we're all playing blue decks.
Yes. That's true.
Just Crimson wisps your thing into blue. Oh no, it has to be red.
Alright. Just chilling.
Oh boy. Oh boy, oh boy, oh boy.
Ooh. Oh, trample, kill him.
Evacuation now.
Well, Crimson's letting that one go.
Just passing. So, you know, it's all you after this. I do need to leave up mana in case, I don't know, somebody decides they want to kill me or something like that.
Oh, boy.
Sounds like something Tomer might do.
Yeah, that's definitely what I can do on this board with one feather and a bunch of land and a bunch of counter spells.
Isn't that how you win? Don't you one-shot someone with feather? What is the actual win con?
Feather.
It's recasting Fists of Flame over and over again, apparently.
You know Tomer's building up the ultimate hand, right? You know this right now.
Yes.
I think his hand is actually bad.
In my hand, as opposed to on the board, like everybody else. Yes.
I'm not really on the board, so you don't have to worry about that. It is a good idea, though, that you don't attack Tomer. I'll tell you that right now.
What am I going to attack into? There's zero attacks for me. Yes. I'm just going to cast my Swiftfoot Boots.
Oh, there's the end of all interaction.
Oh, no.
Oh.
The feather. That's definitely the problem.
I do have things, so like I'm okay with that.
All right, I'm done.
What's that?
I've got my eye on you, Richard. I've got my eye on you.
Maybe you should have your eye on Seth's walls over there.
Once again, it depends.
Okay.
Remember, Seth, if you for sure don't kill me. We're friends. You go wild.
Yeah, we're friends. I mean, if you have to die eventually, it'll be after everyone else.
Cool.
Maybe we just like don't kill each other, and I just get to draw cards until I mill out. I'd be fine with that too. Get rid of Richard and Tomer, and then just let me cast my walls, and
I mean, that
would work.
That doesn't sound terrible.
But then Moto will win. Moto definitely crashed.
Yeah, exactly. At a point,
you basically
Moto
have until
win.
Turn 11, and then it's free for all. It's like a coin flip on whether or not Moto kills you.
We're in turn 9 now. We're getting close.
Yeah. The difference between last time, though, also is the fact that last time Feather was here, we kind of didn't really have anything that got on board.
That's true. We sat around and did a lot of nothing.
Alchemist Refuge? That's concerning.
Yeah. Got you now, crew.
I really miss Three Fairy. Like, Richard's drawn so many cards by now.
Look at Seth's library. I actually ramped lands out of my deck. Look at Seth's library and on board position.
Seth's going to just draw more walls and stuff like that.
That is very true.
I'm just pumping my elephant by +1/+1.
Like, Seth can only win by attacking currently.
How am I going to win without attacking?
That is a good question.
How is Tomer going to win without attacking? All right, we will just chill here.
Okay.
Ooh. Hmm.
You get
remember
overrun effect. All your creatures get +0/+7.
Okay, Krim. Do you?
The negotiation
begins.
Let's
think about this. 1, 2, 3. That's. Oh, my Arcades. Do you wanna oh, is it worth losing Arcades?
Are you asking for a board wipe?
He has a retribution
in
the meat.
Sort of. It's a board wipe, but I feel like it could benefit both of us if we team up a little.
It's a board wipe, right?
Well, it's not a full board wipe.
Well, I lose my board.
No.
No.
Oh, then okay.
But let's see. We get Feather, Tatyova.
Oh, is it Dusadon?
All right. Krim, will you back this up with a counter if you need to?
Yes, if I don't lose my board.
You're not going to lose your board.
Oh, then yes.
let's see. Actually, I should. Hang on. I guess I should cast my walls before Arcades dies.
You're doing Dusadon? Little power 3 or greater?
Not exactly. Similar, but it's a not Dusted On precisely. It's a little riskier than that.
curious to what it is if it's not that.
1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7.
Once again, it's power, right? Not CMC, because
yeah, no, it's power. You'll be fine. It's not gonna blow up your stuff.
Nice.
Yes, we do.
Seth's board is like on moto, is just gonna explode.
We do have a lot of walls. 1, 2, 3, 4. I guess we play this. In case we haven't drawn enough cards yet.
Sure.
And then we play a card called Fell the Mighty.
Oh, nice. Nice. I love this card. And we will
target Mentor of the Meek.
You're doing this before you can attack?
I'm not attacking. I'm drawing cards.
Yo,
I don't want to kill you, Tomer.
Pump the Mentor. Do you have a pump spell?
Oh, man. That would be so funny. Oh,
that would actually be a blowout.
Yeah, don't have a single pump spell.
It would
spell.
Just get countered, though.
It's fine. Let it, like, you only have so many counters. If you can pump it.
Don't pump it, Tomer. Actually, I guess it doesn't really matter that much.
Like, if Tomer pumps it, though, like...
That wipes the board.
The biggest thing that I care about is the Moloku, so...
Yeah, Moloku is going to die.
Actually, pumping it doesn't... Well, pumping it saves the feather. That's about it, right?
Yeah, it saves the feather.
Oh, the Tatyova.
Saves Tatyova.
Oh, the Arcades. He actually might be fine.
Right, Arcades.
Like, if Tomer pumps it, I would just let it happen. What you need to do is shrink it. Unless for some odd reason, Tomer pumps it past 11.
Cast rookie mistake. What does it do?
Dude. If you rookie mistake here, that would be so sick.
Give it -2, -0.
Do you even care? All you lose is a feather.
That's my entire deck.
I guess the risk is that it gets countered on the way back down.
It's not like
the risk.
Krim has been countering all my stuff, so
yeah, you guys started off on the should have blown up
my little hell of my hippocamp or whatever.
I mean, if you draw out Krim's counter spells, I might be able to interact.
All right, have fun, Richard.
What are you?
Got him.
That's it.
No, I could have drawn so many more cards.
Uh-huh.
Oh, all right. Well, respect, actually. I love Mana Tide, so.
I drew all the cards and didn't play around Mana Tide.
I like that.
Do you want me to actually counter this?
I guess I don't care that much. Like, it would get rid of the feather, Tatyova, and... Yeah, I mean, I don't really care.
I mean, you have an Arcades, like, you could attack, you could just kill people, like, I was keeping Feather around, because, like, that's basically all I've got at this point.
If I kill people, then I
can't
drawing cards.
Yeah, what a dilemma.
Well, if you want me to kill people, Tomer, I guess.
Sure.
I mean, I wasn't planning on attacking, but if I have to.
That's what I figured would happen if I had Mana Tithe. Like.
You did get Mana Tithe.
Well, it's like, either I take damage or I lose Feather and then get countered on the way back, so...
Only
well, actually, there's
the
no
top.
Guarantee about that, Tomer, because remember, I still need to keep an eye on Richard.
I mean...
You've been keeping an eye on him by saying okay to everything he casts, so you can keep keeping an eye on him.
He hasn't done anything.
I just know that all the counters have been being used on me, so it's like...
Retreat to Kazandu
is the last thing he casted. You can keep as many eyes as you want on
him. Theoretically, Richard could cast something Krim would want to counter.
Theoretically, although Seth's been casting all those spells. but what's in my hand is scarier.
Krim likes the walls.
Yeah, the walls.
And that's worked out in my favor.
Wait. Is Moloku a wall? No.
Hey, you guys should have played more walls. And then Krim wouldn't counter your stuff either.
Like, walls are pretty cool. I remembered that I think like Carnage Tyrant was relatively budget.
Is it? It's a thing, isn't
it? So I had Detection Tower.
Wow. There goes
Swift Spear of Carnage Tyrant goes all the way to 5 tick EDH week.
You never know.
Wait a minute. So if you have Shroud, you're okay?
Get around Veil of Summer.
Yeah, sure. I mean, not the uncountable part, but... ready for it.
Yeah, it's only 42 cents on Modo, so in theory, someone could have it.
Whoa, main phase casting spells. It's gotta be a scary sorcery.
Are we getting, like, evacuated?
Why would he main phase it?
Wait. Oh, Gadwick.
Wow, Gadwick. For one, this is...
Crims Kali up that counter spell.
Wow.
Giving up 3 cards to leave up the counter.
Wow.
100%.
Wow.
Oh, man. And now, we just pass, right? Like, I don't think there's a reason for me to do anything. Now, of course, I guess I could get mana tithed by like Seth on top of it.
Stop casting Fist of Flames. Does you have a one drop?
I'm looking for a board wipe.
You don't have a one drop that does the same thing?
I just tried to board wipe.
I mean, I had to discard Panic because I skipped a turn. Because
you panicked?
Yeah, I panicked. And, yeah, and then my Crimson Wisp and Shelter got countered, so... Not a lot to do here.
What is in your hand?
At least
not
I upgraded
one mana
Tomer's
cantrip.
Draw spell to 2 mana.
Oh, boy. Sure. Sure.
I still feel like Feather could one-shot someone at some point.
Yeah, I'm pretty scary, you guys.
I'm pretty sure you have enough toughness just to, like, block all of this. Like, put through all the all combat the tricks.
I mean, you what, have fight as one, so you could survive most board wipes.
I'm actually getting low on walls, though. That's not good.
You've drawn it all. The remainder of your deck is lands. That's all you've got.
I'm going to have to start sacking walls to try to draw more walls.
This will be fun. Let me think here.
Detection Tower and then Pongify. No, Rapid Hybridization.
The Detection Tower is really just here for Carnage Tyrants. Because I legit remember that card is budget.
Ooh. Oh, boy. What are we getting flashed in?
I mean, you're free to target a creature of mine. But only once.
Here, I'll play this.
Oh, so
much card draw.
Okay, Mr. 68 cards in library. We must not talk here. This is after I missed this pilgrimage, migration path, and terramorphic expanse.
I'm sure Seth has something to blow up enchantments.
Okay.
I don't know if there's a wall that does that.
I'm going to be honest with you. That doesn't kill me yet.
Okay.
You know that's bait. Like, we all know that's bait.
Sylvan Library is insane.
Yeah.
Wow, that's really good with Teferi's Angel's Insight. Huh.
See, like, I have answers in my hand. The problem is, if I use them, I'm just going to die.
No, you wouldn't. Why would you?
Because then Richard just attacks me.
I mean,
they're friends, Tomer.
Maybe.
Yeah, that is a concern.
Wait, whose turn is it paused on?
At least it's, now, Seth, you have more of a reason to attack Richard,
what?
Right?
We have to be friends, Tober, because the guy with the crazy board is friends with the guy with all counter magic. So we must cobble together
our
resources.
I'm not all counter magic, okay?
You know what? Yeah. You know what? I can stop this. I'm not going to. You
stop
guys
it,
figure
oh,
it out.
Tomer.
You guys
Tomer,
figure it
well,
out.
No, Tomer, listen. Wait. You're worried about Richard killing you if you do it. What about if I kill you if you don't do it?
Just go ahead and do
it. That's not a very convincing argument.
Wow. Okay.
I'm at 27. You guys have dogpiled me and I'm not doing anything all game. You guys figure it out.
You could do something, Tomer.
I'm going to press okay to this.
Richard's drawing more cards than you.
Yep.
Oh, Tomer.
I have been beat.
We could have been friends.
Oh, yeah, we definitely, yep. Mm-hmm.
As I said, I haven't done anything to Tomer since I counted him in the beginning.
Oh, so many cards are being drawn.
I don't have anything,
Us has
got
to be bad.
Yep, I could have blown it up.
Oh, Tomer.
But I didn't.
You could have been the hero feather. I would have taken back all the mean things I've said about you behind your back.
I guess
you'll
just have
feather,
to
feather.
I guess you'll just have to attack Richard, right, Seth?
No, I'll just let the blue decks figure it out.
Oh, I don't want to kill Tomer.
Okay,
but he's letting Richard draw more cards than me. Richard has a huge board, really. Like, if he ever activates Bloku, he needs so many blockers.
The guy that has again 30 power of trample.
Yeah, I just don't know.
Talking about huge boards here.
I mean,
he wanted to wipe the board before even attacking. I don't understand.
Technically,
I just don't understand.
30 toughness of trample.
You could have just attacked and then post main freaking use the thing.
But did you really want me to just attack you?
I mean, you want it to be aggro, right? I don't know. I'm not doing anything this game. You could attack, you know, someone who's actually ahead on board, too.
Yeah, Richard has Maloku, though. They're
you have generous gift
things.
In your hand.
Yeah.
You have the answer to Maloku.
I forgot that you guys knew about that.
I'm trying to get us to use our cards while you just draw cards and build a board. Get out of here.
That's right. You guys remember? You guys know about that generous gift.
At least know you aren't trying to generous gift any of my stuff.
Yeah, I'm at this point, I'm just trying to play to my only outs as opposed to trying, like, police the board and then die because I police the board. That just doesn't seem good.
What is your out, like a sweeper?
Yes.
Probably like Blasphemous
I desperately need a sweeper. Because I have 4 non-land permanents on the battlefield.
But what about the God's Willing, Cloud Shift, Trade Routes?
Okay. Wow, not flashed in. Interesting. Wow, that's a lot of card draw, too. I guess you're going to outdraw me, Richard.
At this point, Richard's going to draw 100
yeah,
cards.
Yeah, but
so.
I don't have big creatures. I need to get my finishers. And even then, you guys have, like, so many creatures that I don't know that it'll even work anymore. I was not expecting... a creature
focused. You
can
bounce all your lands.
Oh, yes, to make 1/1s. Yes.
They all pay for themselves, like a bird, though.
I'm surprised Moto's surviving this.
Don't curse it.
It's only turn 10. Give it
Let's not
3 more turns. I think it was turn 13 or so that it crashed last time. So we have like 3 more turns.
You're more than welcome to use that generous gift.
I'm out of walls.
And then just attack.
We're going to...
Draw some cards? I'm going to draw some cards, though?
I wish, but I don't have any walls. I think I'm going to have to start sacrificing...
Attack! Seth literally just attacks them.
Attacks
them. How do I deal with Richard, he says, with generous gift in hand to deal with the Black Warrior Forge and a bunch of creatures?
You have enough power to kill every one of us here, pretty much, if you decided to swing at one person.
All right, let's see what happens if we do this. Okay, you know about the generous gift. All right, we'll do this.
Just don't target my stuff. Hey, that's fine with me. Weird.
We'll see what happens. This is so much less fun than drawing more cards, though.
Fair. Fair assessment.
1, 2, 3. All right.
They could have been 3 mentor triggers this turn.
So I really have to start attacking.
It turns out, yes.
All right, if you insist. Richard probably has some shenanigans over there.
But how, like, once again.
Well, all right, Richard.
I'll do my best to help
Here
you.
Here we come. I guess mentors probably shouldn't attack. All right. Yeah, we'll see what happens.
I'm super dead. Let's see. How much is this? 12, 16, 20, 27, 30.
Do you not have anything?
Technically alive.
Don't block.
Well, let's see. Crimp has a counter spell for anything I really want
to
do.
No, I don't. I have a detection tower activation.
In case someone plays Carnage Tyrant.
Yeah. I'm over here just ready for Carnage Tyrant.
Well, it's soft size foot boots.
Can I tell you that?
Activate Pongify Carnage Tyrant. We've won.
Nailed it. Got him.
Is Richard not blocking?
I have to see which one of these walls is like worth blocking.
I mean, if you kill Arcades, then all of them do 0 damage. So
yeah, I can't kill Arcades.
Oh.
Okay, this one is a bad wall. This one. I guess demonic wall in case he can move.
Dude, if you return to the ranks after like a ton of your walls die, you can draw a lot of cards.
Ooh. I like the sounds of that. Block, block, block. Alright, so I guess we do this.
Plus 0, tell plus 5. Yep.
We bar the door?
Yes!
Whoa!
That snap resolves on my end.
The overrun.
It's building your own overrun with Primal Rage, bar the door, and walls.
All right. Let's get this evacuation countered.
I am actually fine with this. I kind of hope it resolves because then I get to recast my walls and draw cards.
Oh boy.
I gotta try, right?
I mean, I have 2 colorless lands, so unless you know of a colorless counterspell.
I think this kind of counts as Crim killing you, Richard, because I was fine with evacuation resolving. He is the one with the counterspell.
No, I think the 50, 60, 70 power coming
Don't blame
through.
The walls. Don't blame the walls.
I
they
see
just
you,
want to draw
Crim.
Cards.
I tried to tap the Stover Star Compass.
Wait, what? How does he tap
Sneaky.
The Star Compass?
He has Gadwick on the battlefield. Very
so is this? Is this the first game of the season that you haven't won, Richard?
I haven't won every single game. Have I? I don't think so.
I think, well, it depends if we count last game as a win.
I do respect that, Richard. You are very humble.
I actually, hold on, very humble. How many games this season have we had?
Last game was Modo, sort of, but Richard was going to win in like one more turn for sure. So we've had what? This is episode 5, I think, maybe, that we're playing right now.
We need the stats. Someone in the YouTube comments, pull up the stats.
Literally every single game, Richard has won. Stats, fact, I'm calling it out. Other than Modo
if it
fails.
Hasn't ended in a Modo draw, I think Richard has won almost
But all of our games like ended in Modo fails.
We don't deserve... Modo's the hero we don't deserve, but the one we need.
True.
Because it's like, oh, Richard's going to win again. Let me just swoop in and...
It saves us. It saves us from Richard occasionally.
Yeah. Is this even lethal? No, it's not lethal.
It's way lethal.
Oh, it's trample. It's trample. Okay.
Yeah, you guys are all dead. I don't know how Crim thinks his evacuation is going to save
Primal
him.
Rage?
Oh, no. That's because I have my own stuff for if Seth hits me.
Well, one down.
Yep.
Minus 11.
And then
at least you have an emblem still.
Okay, I'm going to count it. I'm just kidding.
Force of negation. Got him.
All right. Seth, we're still friends, right?
I mean, I said I'd kill you last, so for now, there's still one other person. But eventually right. The walls are coming for you.
Yes, yes. I understand. Okay. That's a fun magic card.
Island?
Yes, I do enjoy me some islands. Okay.
See, I knew there was a reason we're friends. The walls knew that you had walls too.
Look, dude, I can't tap down Tomer's Star Compass a second time, so it actually untaps it after that. Alright. So, let's see here. What do we have? All right.
Fist of Flames has been cast so many times. Fist of Flames for the 19th
time. I'm out of control, you guys. I'm out of control. Look at all this card draw I'm doing.
Kill him.
All right.
Are we getting back a counterspell?
Yeah, it's unwind.
Oh, my God.
yeah, and... You know, per the usual, just passing, just your friendly neighborhood Drakes. At some point, though, we'll get a little wild. At some point.
Yeah.
Can you go?
Oh, man. I still can't deal with Seth's army of walls currently. I guess I can if you, like, but it requires something to happen.
Can you kill me this turn, Tomer?
No.
Oh.
Is the expedition in budget?
Ooh.
Ooh. Yeah. If this were paper, I would say definitely not.
Well, let's see if I... Wait, what can this get me? A lot of mana. Can I get a board wipe? Nope, we cannot. Okay.
Board wipe? Hold on, where?
Nowhere. let's just... Do this again.
I feel like we've only seen four cards from Tomer's deck. Oh, man.
We just see him again and again and again.
Oh, no.
You have nine cards in hand, right? You gotta be able to do something.
Yeah, you'd think, right? 1, 2, 3... No, it's too much mana.
Okay, so.
Again, 1, 2, and then I'll have 1, 2, 3, and blow up two things. Maybe.
Don't blow anything up?
Don't blow anything up.
Oh, I mean on my board? I haven't hit you at all, Tomer. Just remember that.
yeah, okay.
I've been a good boy. I've just been sitting here.
I just like equip this and still no, I'm dead on the swing. I don't know how to get out of this. Choose. I guess I can do this.
Is it a spell that targets my stuff?
No. I think I'm dead. Tap. 1, 2.
You could, like, to get around Kira's shield, you could always just target it with a cheap spell, which you have, like, only 9 cards in hand. But I don't think you care about my stuff. I think you need to get...
Are you actually dead if I attack you?
I mean, he's dead if
I think so. I'm at 27.
It's like... Oh, there's Krim, too.
Oh, just like...
I mean,
any individual.
Seth,
player.
Wow, do you just assume I have nothing ever to attack with? It's a safe assumption.
Shadow Spear gives lifelink, though. That helps.
Tap this, tap.
And I'm definitely sacking a wall to draw a card at the end of your turn.
Ridiculous.
I mean, maybe I don't die. I don't know.
Settle the wreckage?
Oh, please, no.
Settle the wreckage would be so sick.
Oh, that would, yeah. That would
I think
really
that might
bad.
Be the sweeper.
Yeah,
and, like,
I don't
some
know.
Of the ragage is kind of cheap, right?
You may just go with this.
Mm-hmm.
That's it. All done.
All right. Well, we will sack a wall.
Wow.
Which is our worst? Wall of Blossoms, I guess.
Wow. After everything it did for you. Why are you going down attack power?
This is about trying cards, Grim.
You've already done that.
not enough.
He has Richie four cards for me. What do you mean? Not.
He's driving into close. The swan song, so he can kill.
Not even
him.
Halfway there.
Yeah, like you've drawn. Everyone here has drawn more than I have.
I need to draw more walls that I can sacrifice to eventually draw more walls.
But hear me out. What if you just kill people?
What?
Oh, this is turn 11. Oh boy,
yeah. This is the moto turn. Like
we're getting to the moto stage of the game.
We're in the end game now.
Yes. Oh, it's a. All right, let's think about this. How much am I? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11. All right. So I guess we first, play some more card draw.
Oh, oh man, hold on. Let me think. I can counter that and do that.
I mean, you have to unwind in hand.
I mean, I don't know why
you
this matters.
You two things.
He has drawn a lot of cards.
He draws like three off every creature. What does the fourth card matter?
Yeah. That's the reason why it doesn't. That's why I'm thinking about it. Like, yeah, sure, dude. You got it.
All right. Now we get to draw cards.
Okay.
Sure. Oh, Toby, you probably have an answer to this too, don't you? Because you said you had an answer to Richard's enchantments.
It but doesn't matter when it resolves. Anything. I don't have a counter spell in hand.
Now I can sack all my walls to draw cards.
What is going on?
it's a Thassa's Oracle deck.
At least do it after you attack. All right,
fine. I didn't want to use it.
Tomer. Well, okay.
How does this help?
That's disappointing.
You can't cast more spells this turn.
That just enrages me and cuts off my card draw and makes sure that I attack
anything,
you.
That also resolves.
Oh, my card draw, Tomer.
I guess your turn's done.
You can still draw cards.
Yeah, but I can't. Oh, I can't cast more walls, though.
But hear me out. You can't attack with the ones you have.
Oh, that's a wall. Oh, and that's a wall that draws cards. Oh, I would have drawn so many cards this turn, Tomer.
I know.
I'm disappointed in you.
Tomer's forcing you to kill people.
I know. I'm trying my best not to.
You can murder me, but I will stop at nothing to make sure you don't draw more cards in my face. That's the actual torture. Death is a sweet release, Seth.
All right, let's. I don't even think I have lethal on you, honestly.
Not with that attitude.
4, 8, 12, 16, 23.
I mean, remember that I also have creatures.
I don't have anywhere near lethal on you, honestly.
You don't have one of numerous pump spells.
But what if I have creatures, Seth?
I mean, we do have to race Moto, so I guess we attack.
Correct.
I'm surprised you don't just activate Crashing Drawbridge so you can swing with Wall of Mulch.
Yeah, I guess that might be better. Uh-oh.
Draw a card.
The stat of this game is going to be times that Fist of Flame was cast, because it is.
Yeah, you're
going to
crash the game
high.
Casting Fist of Flame that many times.
Maybe that's the goal. Are you trying to give Moto the win with Fist of Flames?
Yeah, I'm playing next level. Oh, boy. All right, let's do this. Defender. You don't have any blink effects. I got to stop the crash and drawbridge.
Yup. Well, that silence was so sad.
Oh, what?
Deny the life.
Oh, yeah.
Deny the life gain.
Yeah, that's bad for me.
Oh, the power move.
15. I'm dead.
It's not that much damage.
Krim has lethal on me.
Oh, yeah, I guess Krim. Is Krim going to steal this game? Am I going to get punished by being friends with Krim?
Never. We're friends.
Maybe.
Never.
You have a lot of drakes and a lot of counters.
I guess if he has like a coat of arms, but there's no way that's in budget.
Well, there's like
a coat of arms itself is also just in budget.
There's a 2-man enchantment. It's like something winds. So it gives like flying creatures. There's also like anti-gravity thing, the gravitational shift, which is like flying creature gets +2/+0. It's a bunch of ways.
Hilariously, that doesn't actually hurt my walls very much by giving them -2/-0.
Let's see here. Oh, wait. Undo.
Blue.
No. It's actually not blue that I'm going to name.
I mean, it's not that. It was just like white and he returns 4 things.
What color was... Or do you choose after it resolves?
Yeah, after it resolves.
That's a suspicious question, Seth.
Well, I could potentially sack some stuff, but if I don't know what color he's choosing, that would be risky.
Just red.
What? I'm at 5. What? Oh,
my walls. It was white. All right. Oh, and now you can counter the Arcades to keep me from... Oh, no. I think I'm going to get Talrand.
I don't know about that.
I think it's possible. At least I still have card draw a little bit.
So Tomer could have, maybe one answer, but no matter what, that's already more than enough to kill him, so I guess... Do you have any flyers I don't know about? Cool.
You're attacking with everything?
No, I do not have flyers at the moment.
No, you're sending 3 at 7. Wow, he really wants Tomer dead. You have a Kira. I'm not sure how Tomer.
That's the one thing. I'm wondering, is that a line where I'm like, actually
really,
worried?
Really hates me, Richard. I don't understand.
I'm sending only 3 things at Tomer, right? Talrand. I mean, I'm definitely sending Talrand at you.
Sure.
I guess Gaddy. Yeah, you're probably right. I can just go with that. Okay.
All right, what's that sideboard card? Target player, sacrifices an attacking creature.
I also do not have anything. Ugh. How do we deal with this?
Maybe teaming up with the person that has stated, I have answers for your board since the very beginning.
Yeah, that's
backed by counter spells and a Drake Arby was not the brightest.
It worked out
second
for a
place.
While.
At least, no matter what, I've got second place. I don't care.
Seth has 12 cards. You can keep jamming cards until something good resolves. Krim only has 5.
Correct.
And he draws 3 cards every time he plays something. So at least 2.
Correct.
Right.
Well, I guess we start with Arcades. See what Krim has to say about that.
Arcades?
How do you feel about Arcades, Krim?
That's fine.
I was not expecting that.
Arcades doesn't necessarily kill me yet.
that is true. Well, I guess we just keep casting walls. That's kind of what the deck does.
And, you may as well attack, right? I mean,
your deck is a little suspicious.
There's no way you win without attacking. I know that. Right?
Finally, after 3 seasons, Aetherize is going to happen.
It's going to actually happen.
We'll see.
Well, I'm going to draw cards first. Maybe I can find a silence.
That silence was so good.
Kept me from drawing a lot of cards.
Oh man.
I mean, I had I wanted to use a silence to find, I have 4 board wipes in the deck. And I was pretty confident once I got one of the board wipes down, I would have been okay. to crawl back, and I wanted the silence as a backup. But then I drew Aurelia's Fury, which I had enough mana to cast any of my board wipes and Aurelia's Fury, which also is a silence effect for 3 mana.
So
I was like, I was going to just like stop you from like for sure killing me that turn by chaining like a bunch of walls and then casting Crashing Drawbridge. And I didn't really want to cast it because I thought maybe Grim would answer something, but he didn't. So then I cast Silence because I knew it was like solo there.
I mean, like, but like at the same time, the Zendikar Resurgent or whatever, it's just like, as Richard mentioned, kind of just like, eh.
No, it's all the mana that he was going to have and also card draw. So he could have chained like a bunch of spells that turn and maybe killed both of us. Right? Like,
yeah.
Made like 10 extra mana and he would draw like 5 extra cards.
Well, I guess we keep going. I might just deck myself. Every wall is a lot of cards at the moment.
Yeah.
Thassa's Oracle.
Just, I guess.
Lab Man.
That's, yeah, Lab Maniac's not a wall. Hold on.
Grim's at 39? Ugh, that's a high life total.
I've already done my part. I've gotten to second place. So from here on out, it doesn't matter.
Wall?
Yeah, yes. I've said yes to so many other walls. But this one, the hover barrier, this is the one that's got to go.
I mean, at this point, Krim can't even kill Seth anymore.
Why not?
That's what I'm hoping. If I play enough...
He has enough flying walls that I think you got to... It'll be a while before you can actually punch through.
Well, there's a Gatwick. He can tap down some of the flying walls.
Oh, yes, that's true.
Reliquary Tower.
Oh, now there's no tapping down with Gatwick anymore. Oh, no, only Wall of Tangle Cord. I thought it was any creature.
No, yeah.
Oh, if everything had reach, it'd be so good.
24 cards in hand. 25 cards in hand. Do you even know what cards are in your hand anymore, Seth?
You might crash Moto. You might actually just crash Moto over doing this.
I'll give it one more turn.
Just playing for the Moto win. We're
getting to that danger zone. Turn 13 is when things fall apart.
Watchdog? Draw 3.
Sure.
I'm not even sure what I'm looking for. Carnage Tyrant? Did I put a Carnage Tyrant in this deck?
He's got the detection tower.
Baby. We came ready.
Can you kill me this turn? You don't have enough drakes to kill me this turn.
I mean, you have so many creatures. You just attack them with like half your creatures and force out the Aetherize.
But why would I do that now when I'm not close to dead?
Well, then you slowly take like 10 or 20 a turn until you actually pull the trigger, right?
Oh, yeah, of course.
I mean, I guess that's the plan. And then you hope he recasts the walls and decks himself? That's the counter plan?
I think that might be a possibility. You have 29 cards in hand, right?
Yeah.
I do have a lot of cards.
30 cards in hand, 29 in deck.
Are you gonna try to deck me?
Oh,
you did have that random didn't say please. Maybe you have random mill cards.
No. Why would I play mill cards? That game plan is ridiculous. You can't mill a table.
Oh, that's a good one.
Let me see here. So change your life total with tree redemptions. Shield Sphere.
My best wall. It's a free ancestral recall.
I mean,
it's
yes.
6, yeah.
It's so good. I think I'm almost done, though. I'm running out of mana.
Man, for what? Some kind of fancy counterspell?
Well, I guess we can play this, though. I'm just playing it all. We're playing everything.
Put it all
for the
there.
Best.
All right.
Draw some cards. We're up to 36 cards in hand.
All right.
That's pretty good.
So if I draw a wheel, you lose, right?
Oh, Krim, no, 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 no. You don't have... Are there wheels on a budget?
Yeah,
oh,
no. There's no way Windfall is that windfall. Cheap. Do you think it's that cheap? How much is Windfall?
I don't think so.
I was thinking those would be too expensive, but if they're not, then you will definitely get me.
Wall
of all right, that's it, Krim. That is it. That's all I can do.
You have 36 cards in hand, that's it?
Well, no, 38, technically, after these resolve.
Sorry, my bad.
All right. I want to see, like, a Gauntlet of Might or something, Blue Sun Zenith kill.
yeah, I mean, I guess if you want to etherize those two walls, I'm fine with it.
That's only your creatures, right? Deal each creature you control.
Where is Arcades? Yeah, it's only his creatures.
Do you have any mana up?
No.
Do you run no counter magic in your deck?
Counter magic? I need room for card draw. there might be a little somewhere, but it's mostly walls. All right, Krim, do your worst.
All right. So, let's see. Is there like any random sacrifice abilities here that I... Are there any sac outlets that I don't know about?
There are what lots.
What are you trying to do to me?
Nothing.
What is happening?
It's going to take all your creatures.
Cyclonic Rift.
Uh-huh.
7 mana only? What is this?
Yeah, I'm very confused. Sac outlet.
Maybe he just takes Arcades and then that's it.
Yeah, that would still be good. I guess it could be like mass manipulation.
Yes. Yes, that's exactly what it could be.
Ooh, all right. Arcades down. And you get to tap.
Oh, right. I have to respond to this nonsense. Right. What here has reach normally?
There's a couple of hover barrier flies. And Tangle Gore could gain reach, but I don't have mana up. And Wall of Denial flies, but I don't think you can tap that down because of Shroud.
Yeah, that won't matter.
I still don't see how you have lethal this turn, though.
It's, It'll be fun.
What is happening? I'm so confused. Okay. Well, we will block. And block. And block. All right. What is going on, Mono Blue Deck? Aha! Does life might actually matter?
Whenever a creature with defender blocks,
that's actually really good.
Oh, I didn't even see that. You have so many walls. Oh, well, whatever.
Okay.
So you took 25. Like nothing for that, I think, pretty much?
Yeah, there was a little, but...
I think you took like 4?
Alright, show me the Tobin's veto.
So my Arcades is gone. Which
means surely you have high alert.
Yeah, it means we have to play high alert.
Alright.
Shields down.
Unwind.
Never mind. Tobin's veto. Let's see it.
Hmm.
Yeah, if you can't attack, then I don't think you win.
Let me think here. Any of these here matter? Da 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 da. That has. Okay. I guess this is the only one that matters currently.
All right. Let's see this. Swords Arcades?
Uh-huh.
Kira.
Oh. I was wondering why you were not more upset about that.
All right, now follow the second swords.
So you do have counter magic.
I have a counter spell. One.
Uh-oh.
Oh, Kerm's dead? Oh. That's it?
Oh, there might be death now. We'll see.
Yeah, I'm dead now. I'm dead now.
He's definitely dead.
I'm dead now.
Then we will...
It's as if letting him draw 38 cards. Was not wise.
I got my desired result.
I was a little bit worried that Seth had like was in blue and just did not run a single counter spell.
But he could have ran. I feel like he could have just played like four high alerts or something, like all the high alerts, and Krim wouldn't have enough counter magic to keep going.
I mean that too. There's like one more that's green. I think it's like reckless assault or something.
Assault formation.
Yeah, that's the one.
Yeah.
There's my ensnaring badge, by the way, Krim. All creatures get a negative 34, negative 0 at the moment.
What is that?
I mean, you just bounce high alert and you win. Oh, wait, no. Then my turn still starts to win. Besides his decks themselves.
I mean, I'm going for the win here. I just want to make it as spectacular as possible.
Oh, I'm definitely dead. Like, I would have to untap, right?
Unblockable.
Darn counterspell.
And then this one's for you, Grim.
By the most basic. The OG counterspell.
And then,
I'm definitely going to take all the damage. I want to get hit by this Triumph of the Hordes.
We're not done yet.
Oh, but of course, why would we be?
We're going to try to break the infect record here. Tower defense, assault formation.
Yeah,
just in case.
Oh, there it is.
Yeah.
You didn't even need the counter spell. You could have just forced through any of these cards.
I probably could have won either way.
Yeah, you would have.
It's almost as if drawing a billion cards unopposed.
There is a reason I like drawing cards so much. It's not just that I like drawing cards, but sometimes it's actually good too.
But the silence was silly, you guys. It doesn't matter if he has infinite mana and draws even more cards, you guys.
Well, here we come, Krim.
You got me.
Skip past your attack phase.
Oh!
You did how it. Much effect is it?
You clicked it.
I think it was like negative like 200 like infect or something like that. Yeah, 200.
Exactly 200 infect.
He nailed it.
Perfect.
Is there a moto limit to how much counters, or was it exactly 200?
Oh, I actually don't know. I know the token limit's 200, so maybe there is a limit at 200.
Yeah, because like what? That's 11.
Oh my god.
15. I mean, yeah, you can sit here and do all the math, but I got infected this game. That's great.
I think it's about right.
By all the walls. Let's see. Once again, I'm happy to play second place to the walls. I respect that.
I mean, Arcades isn't like a slouch. Like I've seen Arcades combo decks, and they're pretty nasty.
Oh, yeah. Yeah, this was not really a combo-y build of Arcades. I did have, like, I guess the most combo-y things I had were Ghostway and Eerie Interlude to, like, mass blink my team, but that was also kind of my Wrath Protection, like my 5-ticks version of Teferi's Protection or whatever, so I could save all my creatures from a sweeper. Mm-hmm. I think, I have to say, overall, before I talk a little more about my deck, overall, I was mostly impressed that this felt like real Commander to me. Like, all of our decks, really, like, Feather, Richard was drawing a bunch of cards with his deck, he had Sylvan Library going with Teferi's Angel's Insight, Krim had a ton of drakes with Talrand and a bunch of counters, like, even on a 5-ticks budget, it wasn't like Pauper Commander Week or something.
Yeah.
Where we've had some games where it's like, ugh, like, okay, like, it's nice that it's budget-friendly, but that was just not a very, like, fun game or real-feeling game of Commander. But this felt like real Commander for the most part, or at least, like, real budget Commander. So you can actually build really powerful decks for 5 tickets, which I think is maybe my biggest takeaway from the week. Otherwise, as far as my deck, it's a bunch of walls. You saw the Fel the Mighty. Those are kind of, like, the biggest shenanigans are stuff that takes advantage of the fact that we have no toughness. So, like, you saw Misha in the Mind Mind Cage really good because it only hurts everyone else. That's like a one ticket or a 0.1 ticket version of Ensnaring Bridge almost. There's a bunch of sweepers, Solar Tide, Fell the Mighty, that care about the power of creatures. Also, Marble Titan makes it so creatures with power 3 or greater don't untap during their untap step, so all my team is fine, but everyone else's stuff won't untap. And that's basically the deck. Play a bunch of walls, have some toughness shenanigans, and thanks to the efficiency of some of the pump spells, like your entire team gets +0/+5 at instant speed for 3 mana. That's insane. Like, that is, they would never print a card like that for pumping power, but when you're dealing damage equal to your toughness, all of a sudden some of these like weird, unplayable, even in limited toughness pumping spells just become absolutely absurd and let you just kill people out of nowhere.
At +4/+0/+4/1 was kind of disgusting.
Yeah, the bar of the door was pretty good. And technically that's even worse than the one that I cast against Krim. Tower Defense is other one, which is +0/+5 and reach for 2 mana instant speed, which is just insane.
The Maisha or whatever, it was super cool. I kind of just, for whatever that legendary enchantment was, I kind of forgot that existed. That's really sweet.
Yeah, that's definitely really sweet in a deck like this, and it might be worth considering for other decks that draw a lot of cards and are more of like control style decks, especially in like the 5-tick format where you can't play Ensnaring Bridge, and even some of the like sweepers, like stuff like Wrath of God isn't expensive, but when you're trying to build on a 5-tick budget, even having to spend like 50 cents on a single card is really tough, and Mishan is like super cheap, so I think it's a pretty decent defensive card, especially if your hand is going to be full of cards. Like, it is dependent on your hand being full of cards. Normally for me that's not a problem, but if you're emptying your hand, it is a little less good.
Yeah, and it seemed like very legit as a Arcades deck in general. Like, if you didn't tell me it was a 5-ticket budget and I just saw it on Magic Online, I would just assume it was like a typical Arcades deck without too many, you know, changes. Like, there wasn't any of like the original dual lands and fetch lands, but otherwise it seemed like all the cards that I would expect from Arcades that, you know, are the cornerstones of the deck, like Reckless Formation and High Alert, and there was even Shield Sphere, when like probably the best wall in the deck. They're all there, and the deck can function really, really well, and did function really, really well. And Arcades, I think, like, stuck on the board for most of the game, but even without that, like, you had 2 enchantments that were good backup options, so it seemed like it was just very effective overall, like, well-rounded.
Yeah, I think Arcades is a pretty good deck to build on the 5-tick budget because, as you mentioned, you don't really lose much except for mana, and we have so many cheap dual lands now that, other than like the fact they come into play tap, which is annoying, your mana is still good even with 3 colors. There's like a critical mass of these random enter the battlefield tap duels, so you can still make 3 color mana without a problem, and all the good walls just happen to be cheap. Like, the best walls in the deck are like Wall of Blossoms, the mana producing walls like Overgrown Battlement, but those are all just like penny cards on Magic Online, so you don't really have to not play anything that is really specifically good with Arcades because of budget, other than not getting like Shocklands and Dual Lands and stuff. But as far as like the non-land cards in the deck, you kind of get to play everything that you want to, and the deck actually is pretty powerful, I think, in the 5-tick format.
Mm-hmm. Well, gotta see Richard's deck. At the beginning, there was quite an explosive start. Tatyova did Tatyova things. But I did notice there were kind of like some changes up from, you know, a budgetless version of Tatyova would be doing like fetch lands and Crucible of Worlds and constant loops of that sort. Your deck, Richard, you didn't have access to fetch lands and Crucible and whatnot. So what was your game plan with the late game and everything?
Yeah, no Crucible. We do have fetch lands, but they're like the bad fetch lands, like Evolving Wilds. But I did manage to fit Rampaging Bailouts in. That was a whole like 85 cents or something. That took up a lot of my budget. You saw the Royal Elemental, and then we had combo finishes with our Cloudstone Curio, the Crumbling Vestige land that like gives you mana and things like that. And then the retreats were combos. I don't think you saw me play Retreat to Coralhelm, but you can combo that. Basically, draw your deck and win with a Lab Man, or draw your deck and kill with a Psychosis Crawler. So there were a couple combo finishes. But other than that, you can just value people out. I had some big X spells, Hydra Broodmaster, Multani could get there, Sylvan Awakening, turn all my lands into creatures. So you still have a good selection of finishers in Tatyova. It's just the support pieces are missing, like Oracle of Moldiah, things that let you play multiple lands per turn are missing. Combos that deal with the graveyard, like Crucible of the Worlds based combos are gone. But I thought the deck was pretty strong overall. It would be pretty strong in a normal week, except everyone this week had a stronger value engine than Tatyova. So while I was drawing cards, Seth was outdrawing me while adding like 5 power on the battlefield with like, you know, and with every creature he casts. So yeah, and then we had some answers, but Krim put his stuff to that, canceling the evacuation. So that was that. I don't know if Boseju's in budget or not, but we need to prepare
probably
for
not,
this.
Probably not. Yeah,
forgot the Boseju.
I thought Tatyova was still good, though. It seemed like it was still pretty strong.
Yeah.
Yeah. Like, yeah, it seems like Tatyova definitely like benefits from like exploration and, you know, some higher budget stuff. So it did seem like there was like a power gap a little bit, but like, I don't know. I was still scared to be Richard. Very much so.
It's still a fairly majority of the game. Expensive deck. Like in paper, it's $240. Yeah. That's probably, you know, that's more than every single budget commander. That's probably more than the average person's EDH deck. So just because it's 5 ticks doesn't mean it's a slouch. And also if you go up to like 10 or 20 ticks, it gets like super powerful. There are a lot of cards that are like $1 that we have to cut because we can't fit it in the budget. But you know, you get to play those. So yeah.
Fair enough. All right, Krim, we gotta see the Drake army kind of assemble. And we gotta see a lot of your answers, which were mostly like counter magic and bounce. But what were you going to do for the late game? Were you just basically just going to assemble 2/2s and kill everybody to 2/2s, or did you have like some other ways of closing out the game?
I just put in every token generator I could find, right? Like Metallurgic Summonings, you know, stuff like that. And of course, like the Murmuring Mystic and the dude that like makes Merfolks, and then you tap 7 Merfolk and you can counter any spell.
Yeah.
And I like, so you just pretty much, it was all just tokens and, try to like, there were some mill win conditions. I just needed to draw them. Like I threw away a Psychic Corrosion. So you did see that there was a subtle mill game plan in there. And in case I drew too much, the game plan was to eventually Psychic Spiral. Because I assumed that I was going to burn through a ton of my own cards. So hopefully, the whole game plan in this was to get one person with Psychic Spiral.
I mean, Seth was very much in Psychic Spiral range, mostly from his own doing. So that would be pretty funny.
That would have got me real good.
I was just hoping for it. But then, and you were tapped out, right? So, that one turn, I was like, okay. So if you do have counter magic, I can resolve a mill spell right now. The wheel I have, you're right, like Windfall isn't like expensive, but I do have Commit to Memory. So I was hoping that maybe I could just use that. A wheel to make it so that you're back down to the normal hand size. Like that's one of my big game plans. And I do have Narset because Narset's only like 12 cents. Like a lot of these cards are seriously 12 cents. Like you had mentioned, Mana Drain is 40 cents. Like, it's 40 cents.
It's in there? Oh, no.
It's 40 cents. It's under 5 ticks.
Gross.
I have listened to the rules. Although, like you had all mentioned, though, these decks are insanely pricey. And it really did feel like in paper, right? Like, my deck is, like, $221. Granted that most of that comes from Mana Drain. I do think that this was, like, a crazy fun game of EDH, right? I think we all, for the most part, kind of did what we wanted to do. It actually felt better than the weeks where we didn't have the weeks where we didn't have a budget. This felt better than some of those weeks, right? So I don't know. I actually really enjoyed the 5 ticks week, and it just shows you like how much you can like get, like, you know, you can get on Modo.
Yeah, and I think it was a pretty good showing overall. Like everybody got to show some powerful decks. And the best thing of all was that Moto didn't crash. So
yeah,
imagine if Moto crashed while we're trying to talk up how good Moto is at playing Magic or playing Commander. That would have been really bad. That would have been really bad. So good job,
Moto. I was genuinely sweating it every time Seth drew an additional card. Because it's always Seth's greed to draw more cards that crashes the game. Like, we had Sliver Week. I was like, Seth, do not cast any more Slivers. Nope, I'm going to cast more Slivers. Moto crashes.
Hammer Monocon, Darman Sliver. Let's draw cards. Yeah, as soon as it passes the 11 mark, turn 11 is when I start to sweat. Like, yeah, I think games and like continue after turn 13. After that, Moto's like, I've had enough, and just let's crash and loop endlessly. So that was good that it didn't happen. As for my deck, it didn't do that well. I think the Crimson Wisps was a good counter, but I goofed a little bit. The deck has basically 10 one mana cantrips, and those are like the heart of the deck. You need to have Feather on the battlefield. You have to have protection for Feather because she is like the entire deck is built around her. So if Feather's not on the battlefield, the deck doesn't really do anything. So you have to have Feather on the battlefield. You have to have protection. And then you ideally really want to have a one mana cantrip so you can cast it multiple times per turn. And I had two in my hand. I had Crimson Wisps and then I had Panic. And the turn that I skipped really, really messed me up. Because I really didn't want to discard my lands, because you really want to hit your land drops with Feather. The deck doesn't really have a lot of explosive ramp. So I really wanted to hit my land drops so I can keep accruing more in value. And I discarded Panic because I had Crimson Wisps in my hand. And that ended up messing me up. Because as soon as Crimson Wisps got removed, I had to rely on Fists of Flame as my cantrip. And that cost double, so I could only cast it like one, two times per turn. And I was only drawing two cards per turn cycle, and I never saw another one of my 10 one mana cantrips. So I was just like severely behind. I was behind like an entire turn essentially because I skipped through it. So I was behind on lands. Everybody else was playing blue or Simic. Two people were playing Simic, ramping like crazy and drawing a billion cards. I just could not keep up, and I was really just hoping to find one of my four board wipes to really just clear out the board and like really let me catch up again. The best one of them all is Razia's Purification. It's 6 mana. Each player chooses 3 permanents they control, then sacrifices the rest. This is like evil, obviously, but in Feather, it's fantastic because all you need is Feather on the battlefield and like 2 mana to cast your cantrips. And you've won the game essentially, because all you do is you have like 2 mana on the battlefield. 2 mana is available to always protect Feather. And then you have your cantrips, both 1 mana, and you just kind of win the game off that. So I was really, really hoping to find Razia's Purification or the other 3 board wipes, and then I would have been fine. I just didn't find any of them. And I was just kind of stuck with like a meh hand for the rest of the game. And I just could not do anything. I had a Sunforger at the end, but it was just too much mana. It's 6 mana to cast and equip. And I did have Magnetic Theft in the deck, which is really good. You pay 1 mana to attach equipment to target creature. So if I got to like cast Sunforger and then fetch Theft and then keep getting it over and over again with Feather, then that would have been a really good Sunforger engine. But I was too slow and I was too far behind. So unfortunately, Feather just did not get it there this time. But I mean, most of the deck is like there. Like, if the difference between a high budget Feather and this Feather is like you have slightly better lands, you have like Sol Ring, a little bit of the faster mana, so Feather comes out a little bit faster. But like all the key cards, like all the cheap cantrips that are the heart of a Feather deck are there. Sunforger is there. I know, memes. But yeah, so like Feather is like a perfect option for it. I didn't anticipate being the arch enemy at the table. I forgot at how strong Feather was the first time. I saw Tatyova and like at Arcades and Talrand. I'm like, three blue players. Obviously, one of them is going to be the archenemy, but I was. So that really did not play well against me. Yeah, so it's a shame, but it didn't help that
you like obliterated us last time you had Feather.
I didn't remember it was such a dominating performance, but apparently.
Well, I definitely remember. I felt that. Like,
so yeah.
Question for you guys. So do you think there's any chance that like 5-ticket EDH could become an actual format that people played? Like, considering the loan program and, like, not in paper, but, like, for Magic Online, could you imagine that being, like, something that was, not, like, Pauper or something, like a digital-only format that was actually a legit format? Or do you think that that would probably never happen?
I would say yes, because of the Cardhoarder program. Because, like, it doesn't really, like, 5 tickets is a very arbitrary number. The only reason why I think it's such a cool number. I mean, it is such a cool number in general because it lets you build high power decks more so than Penny Dreadful. But the reason why it's so tantalizing as 5 tickets as opposed to like 4 or 6 is because you can get a free account on Cardhoarder and you can get all these cards for free. And then once you're bored of one deck, you just return it and you get a different one. And that's really, really appealing. And I wish more people knew about it. Again, like, Cardhoarder did not approach us to do this episode or do any of this promotion. Wizards of the Coast definitely did not approach us. Wizards of the Coast is trying very difficult to make you not know that you could play Commander online. Like, I don't think they've ever promoted Magic Online Commander the entire quarantine. Never have said a peep about it, even though it's, like, such an excellent way to play the game, despite all the bugs and the crashes and everything. Despite all that, it has so many benefits to playing online as an alternative to webcamming that I would have been doing like as much PR as possible to spread the word if I was with the Coast and they have like said nothing about it and seem to not want you to know about it. So if they would promote it, If they would promote it, I think that would be like a huge thing, and maybe 5-ticket Commander could be like a legit format online. It's just a shame that they don't. Like, I don't know why, but they just don't want you to play Magic online, I guess. That was a downer. I'm sorry. I like Modo a lot. I think there's a lot of benefits of playing Commander online, and it's just like, I wish more people knew about it. So here we are.
Maybe someday. I mean, Commander Legends is coming. They've mentioned some stuff about like updating Modo, so we'll see. Like, fingers crossed, maybe it'll start getting promoted. But yeah, I think it would have been the perfect time with all the quarantine stuff to really promote it. So, but yeah, I think it could be a real format, like not necessarily a wizard supported format, but a format that people actually played. I think that's possible.
Yeah, I mean, Penny Dreadful is a real format on Magic Online. It has like a community around it. People are very into it, and that's great. And I think like just building a 5-ticket community around this Cardhoarder free loan account program would be really, really sweet. I mean, I honestly think that the program is really, really good for getting people into Magic, and you get to play like so many different commanders are available online with this restriction. You just stick to the ones that are like came out in the standard set, and you can play pretty much any of them. And it's just cool. Like, you could play Feather for a couple games, then you play Tatyova for a couple games, you play something else for a couple games, and you just get to experience all these decks. And maybe you really like one, and after quarantine, you want to play a paper version. Well, now you just play like 20 plus commanders over 5 tickets or less, and you have like a really good idea of what you like and what you didn't like, and what you want to commit actual money to if you want to do that. So, yeah, I like it. All right, well, that wraps up this game of Commander Clash. Hope everybody enjoyed, and we have stuff next week, I'm sure.
I think we're going the other direction, right? Going CEDH?
Yes, I think that is the plan. We are going to do CEDH, and we're going to do it correct, where it's not going to be like Atraxa's Super Friends. It's going to be real CEDH decks.
Hey.
Real CEDH deck, I'm just saying. that's probably happening next week. Don't hold me to it, but that is the plan. So we'll see how that pans out. And Okay, bye!
Thank you, loyal viewer, for being one of the very few people who actually makes it to the very end of the video. Your reward for getting here is, you guessed it, a relevant plug. If you liked the 5-ticket decks here and are interested in trying out Magic Online with these free decks with Cardhoarder, then check out the 2 articles I did recently showing you how to set up your Magic Online account, how to set up a Cardhoarder free loan account, and each article comes with 5 decks that you can borrow for free, including the Feather List I played and got destroyed with. Great advertising for that deck there, by the way. Both articles are on the screen right now, so you can just give them a click and make that YouTube algorithm happy. Thanks for watching, and stay safe out there.